Good morning and a very warm welcome to Beginning the Day with God on Thursday the 26th of October. The music we're listening to at the moment is Bernadette Farrell's Love Goes On. Let us pray. God of the ages, to whom 1,000 years are like a single day, we thank you for bringing us safely to this morning.
Direct our steps and enlighten our hearts, that in all things we may act with your wisdom, your joy and your love. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. Our reading this morning is from the Gospel of St. Matthew, chapter 26. We continue looking at the passion narrative of Jesus, and today Jesus is before the Sanhedrin. Those who had arrested Jesus took him to Caiaphas, the high priest, where the teachers of the law and the elders had assembled. But Peter followed him at a distance, right up to the courtyard of the high priest. He entered and sat down with the guards to see the outcome. The chief priests and the whole Sanhedrin were looking for false evidence against Jesus so that they could put him to death. But they did not find any, though many false witnesses came forward. Finally, two came forward and declared, "This fellow said, I am able to destroy the temple of God and rebuild it in 3 days. Then the high priest stood up and said to Jesus, "Are you not going to answer? What is this testimony that these men are bringing against you?" But Jesus remained silent. The high priest said to him, "I charge you under oath by the living God. Tell us if you are the Messiah, the Son of God." "You have said so," Jesus replied. "But I say to all of you, from now on you will see the Son of Man sitting at the right hand of the Mighty One and coming on the clouds of heaven." Then the high priest tore his clothes and said, "He has spoken blasphemy. Why do we need any more witnesses? Look now, you have heard the blasphemy. What do you think?" "He is worthy of death," they answered. Then they spit in his face and they strike him with their fists. Others slapped him and said, "Prophesy to us, Messiah. Who hit you?" Thanks be to God.
We continue with this morning's reflection. The irony continues in the court scene where the council tries Jesus. The high priest asks Jesus if he is the Messiah, the Son of God. The phrase "Son of God" meant many things in the Old Testament. A Son of God could be an angel, a particularly righteous person, the Davidic king, or the coming Messiah. So when the high priest asks Jesus if he is the Messiah, he uses the phrase "Son of God" to mean the Messiah. Jesus does something quite extraordinary in his reply. He identifies himself as the Son of Man of Daniel, the book of Daniel, chapter 7, verse 13. Who Matthew interprets as a divine figure. Jesus begins his reply with the words, "I am," alluding to the name by which God identifies himself in the book of Exodus. So in his reply, Jesus not only identifies himself as the Messiah, but as God himself, Small wonder then that the high priest cries out, "Blasphemy!" Believing that Jesus is God, we might look at the response of the high priest and the council and regret their inability to see and believe, even when Jesus tells them who he is. But here there is an even deeper irony in the way in which Matthew tells the story of Jesus. The Jewish leaders might totally reject Jesus here and decide that he deserves death, but his disciples have already deserted him to death. Even Peter follows only from a distance. The ease with which the disciples have hoped for the replacement of the Jewish leaders by themselves as leaders of the nation has already been replaced with the ease with which they desert and distance themselves from Jesus when the challenging times come. And all of this poses the question for us: where are we with the claims of Jesus Christ? They are not always comfortable. Following Jesus' teaching can be truly countercultural and bring us into conflict or profound disagreement and difference of lifestyle with those around us. How do we respond? Are we like Matthew's disciples who talk the talk and then run rather than remaining firm when the time of testing comes? One day the Son of Man will come, and the question we all need to ask is, what will he find us doing? Amen. We come now to our prayers. Father, we pray this morning for your church, for the people and the ministers of the Diocese of Antananarivo, of the Church of the Province of the Indian Ocean. We pray too for the people and the ministers of the other local Christian churches here, for Freddie and Simon and all at Zion Baptist Church, for Adrian and all at Tenterden Methodist Church, for Father Bear and Jolyon Vickers and all at St Andrew's Roman Catholic Church, for Matthew and all at Trinity Baptist Church, and Gilbert and all at Jira Chapel, and Carl and all at the Gateway Church. We pray for ourselves too, that by this day's end we may be found to have been faithful servants of Christ in our thoughts and our words and our deeds. Father, be with us this day, we pray. Be with all your people throughout the world. May they and us devote ourselves to the service of your kingdom of love. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer. Let us now pray the words that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Lord, we thank you for the gift of this new day. We pray that you would bless us in all our actions, our words, and our thoughts, and that we would make the hours that lie ahead an offering in your service.
Amen.
God bless the sky that is above us, the earth that is beneath us, your image deep within us, the day that lies before us.
Amen.